So, fun fact, I actually planned on doing this a little sooner than I did. I shot my first review with a completely different plan and format in mind, which ended up being a little unfeasible as events unfolded. Hell, I even shot the whole thing, but the audio didn't capture, which was a right old kick in the c**. The biggest shame was that I probably could have gotten a much better start than I did, at least going off of this, seeing as I got lucky with a certain anticipated figure 2 months before anyone else seemed to get theirs. So, I suppose now that I'm 10 reviews in, I'll finally get on with that. So, movie toys. They don't tend to be my area of expertise. I got some when I was younger because they were what local shops stocked, and there have been a few Studio Series guys that I like the look of, but I've mostly been in for the cartoonier offerings. But when Studio Series Rise of the Beasts Optimus Prime was revealed, I knew I needed one. When I saw the first Rise of the Beast trailer, I felt a little on the indifferent side to the design given to Optimus. The proportions looked very off with the earlier renders, and the fact that they reduced the red didn't sit too well with me. It felt like quite a downgrade from his excellent design in Bumblebee. But as the renders got updated, and when I saw the film, I came to love this design wholeheartedly, and it's now among my favourite looks for the character. And this figure really does that design some justice in the robot mode. It's frankly immaculate. All the details are accounted for and represented by some of the most decadent sculpting I've encountered. The colours are bright and lively, with a rich and deep blue, and patches of gunmetal help break up the large grey sections found on the design. Little moments of silver jump out too on his face and shoulders, which do well to draw the eye, and the Autobot logos on the shoulders are big and proud. His proportions are great too. They look spot on to the film and are also really aesthetically sound. Aside from the smokestacks, these are a little larger than how they appear in the film for the sake of the truck mode, but you can get kits which provide more accurate stacks. Personally, I quite like the look of the large stacks when he's standing stock straight, although they do crowd the head way too much when you articulate the shoulders. Don't worry, we'll get to the problems there later. I also enjoy how complete the robot mode appears. There are visually no gaps, the colours extend their ways around the figure to the fullest, and he has a very well detailed and organised back, which does have a specially sized port on it to store the sword. This is far and away my favourite accessory he has. It's really nicely detailed and picked out in all gunmetal. It can attach to the wrist in a couple of ways, by plugging it into the outside for a shorter blade or mounting it just above the hand for a very accurate and stable sword accessory. He can also hold it in his hand, but that looks ridiculous. This is not the only accessory meant for him though, as he does come with his gun, sorta. You can flip away his hand to reveal a peg that the barrel of his arm kind of mounts onto, which is neat, but I wish they used that opportunity to make the cannon much larger and more imposing like it was in the movie, or not include it and use the leftover cash to fix some of the vehicle mode issues. You can rotate the arm panels for a more complete look to the cannon, but it does put a little bit of stress on the hinges, so do so at your own risk. Personally, I'm not a massive fan of the cannon, but I do find that if you open up his chest, that's a perfect place to store it. You can also equip his axe from the movie, but that component comes with the lead class Optimus Primal from the Studio Series, which I have reviewed. It's worth a watch. The articulation here is one of the absolute best aspects of this figure. He has overall great ranges on most of his joints, with some additional aspects such as ball joints under the ankle pivots to allow for more up, down, and rotation, some small expressive hinges in the wrists, a fantastic ab crunch that is for the transformation, but it feels way too intentional. Seriously, this guy can touch his own toes. Also, his hips are mounted a little bit forward, so they can't move back that far, but they can extend all the way up if you want them to. All of this makes for great and extremely natural articulation, aside from his shoulders, which are mounted into his torso on struts, which means they instantly crowd his head the moment you move them up. This is a massive shame, as otherwise the posing here is immense, but there's just one important joint holding a lot of poses back. The transformation on this guy is pretty good. It does some interesting and different things, like the front grille inverting to become the back of the robot, and the shoulders taking a couple of extra steps to rotate back instead of the usual backwards butterfly, although this is the reason why the arms articulate the way they do, so I wish they would have approached it differently. Truck mode is mixed. On the one hand, the cab is pretty great. It's pretty clean, a good shape, I like the way they managed to integrate the bull bar sitting forward off the bumper as opposed to the way the mainline figure executed this feature. But once you get past the wheel wells, you notice that there's no ladder or extension of the cab down past them, leaving a large gap. And when you look to the back and you see a complete and total clusterfuck that is the back of the truck, and you wonder if you've actually finished the transformation. There are just a few decisions made here, like choosing not to have the leg pieces fold down more for what I can only assume is for the sake of weapon storage and an attempt at a cab rack. There are some things I like here, such as the way the feet rotate in to make an authentic looking truck bed, but the midpoint is just too bad to ignore. The biggest downside here for me is that the upgrade kits that fix the cab rack to keep the legs solid in truck mode end up making the truck far too long, which I personally find equally ugly. It's just a very flawed section on an otherwise excellent figure. Looking past these faults though, you have a very solid amount of detail on the go. I like the implication of a tiny Autobot logo on the front. These huge smokestacks from the robot mode look fantastic here. Take that, Earthrise, you pile of f***ing lumber. I like the wheels too. Their size are a lot of fun, even if they are lifted from the Bumblebee movie version, or so I've heard. On a side note, I think that figure has a much better truck mode personally. Although I don't hate this one, I can't deny that it has some problems, but I am a fan of the way it scales with some of my deluxe Studio Series cars. I like the details on the front of the cab, and it looks pretty good alongside Primal. I quite like this shell, so I'm gonna let it sit for a moment. Overall, I do really love this figure. It might even be my favorite Optimus, as while it stumbles a little, it isn't afraid to try new things, and a lot of them land. It has some amazing poseability, and the look is pretty great too. I would recommend this figure wholeheartedly. Even though it has the flaws that it does, the robot mode is too good to ignore, and even the vehicle mode has its charms. I hope all you guys enjoy the holidays. There probably won't be a review next week and instead an end of year top 5 list, so be sure to chime in for that, and yeah, thanks for watching.